Hey, space friends, this week I'm talking about microbes that go up in smoke. I mean that in the most literal of senses, microbes that actually go up and get carried away with smoke, specifically wildfire smoke. A lot of times we're thinking about wildfire smoke and all of the ash that it produces and all the ash that gets carried around in the winds. Well, it turns out that microbes also get carried around in those winds and smoke. But the thing that's really cool about this is that there are living microbes in that smoke, not just dead carcasses of microbes getting swished around in the air and smoke, but actual living microbes. Wildfires are something that I increasingly have to deal with here in California, but also a lot of you are probably familiar with all the wildfires that happen in Australia. The thing that's really fascinating about those wildfires is that NASA was able to tell that those wildfires in Australia, actually the smoke from them circled the entire globe. So they were able to visualize how all the smoke goes around the entire globe and then met it right back in Australia where it had started. So smoke from wildfires actually travels a huge distance. And to think about the fact that it carries living microbes in it has a lot of implications. Scientists have also been able to determine the fact that the more intense of a wildfire, the more microbes get lifted into the air. So things like Australia's wildfires probably produced a lot of microbes into the air. Knowing that microbes get carried in the air is nothing new. We've known that at least for a couple of centuries. But what is new is actually determining that there are microbes in smoke that aren't dead, they're actually living. This area of research is not only really fascinating, but it also has a really cool name. It's recently been dubbed pyroaerobiology, and it enlists people with also really cool titles, like fire ecologists like Loretta Kobziar, who are doing this fascinating research and actually studying wildfires up close and personal. Her research team actually went to wildfires in different smoke areas, and they flew drones over smoke with open petri dishes so that they could collect all of these samples and analyze them back in the lab. And what they discovered was that there were just tons of species of bacteria and fungal spores in this smoke, and a lot of them were living. Loretta got inspired to do this sort of research, she says, because she learned about snow machines at a lot of ski resorts actually use bacteria to create ice crystals, and they use this bacteria in the snow machines to create snow. This is a really fascinating thing because microbes are also thought to be able to seed clouds in using a similar mechanism. So Loretta was thinking about, well, if all these bacteria and microbes are being used to form ice crystals, maybe it would be interesting to look at microbes and their interactions with smoke. What she and other researchers have been able to determine has been really fascinating, that smoke is not sterile and it's not just a place of dead microbes, but it's actually a place of living microbes. As I mentioned, this has a lot of implications. For instance, this could affect allergies. As smoke gets transported around the earth, it can affect people's allergies. Also, microbes sometimes are known for carrying diseases. But I don't want to give microbes a bad rap, because microbes can also do some pretty amazing things. They can help protect plants from diseases, they can help protect plants from all sorts of different problems that they might have, and actually make them grow bigger and larger and just have better lives. But also, microbes are some of the first creatures in areas that help restore areas after wildfires. So while microbes are often seen as these disease-causing things or things that cause allergies, they also do a lot of really positive things in the world. So don't group all microbes together, because there's a lot of good things that can happen from microbes being transported around the world as well. What's really cool to think about is how microbe distribution around the globe can happen in so many different ways. Microbes can attach themselves to the wings of birds and get transported around the earth that way, and now we're learning microbes can actually be transported around the earth through wildfires. There's so much more left to learn around all of this, but it's really cool to think about. I think for me, the coolest part of the research was learning that the microbes that they detected in the wildfire smoke were actually a really diverse and large group of different types of microbes. And some of these microbes are known for being heat resistant and some aren't. So this certainly gives you a new thought around what we consider to be extremophiles. If all sorts of microbes can survive wildfire smoke and be transported around still living in wildfire smoke, well, maybe a lot more things on this earth are extremophiles than we've previously thought about. All right, that's it for me this week, space friends. As always, if you're enjoying these videos, head on over to my Patreon campaign and throw in a few bucks. It helps me produce videos like this one, and I'm a team of one, and I always appreciate it. Otherwise, I'll see you next time.